aces and deuces and threes as Jim flips the cards for the celebrities on Cut Shots. And here's the host of Cut Shots, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're very kind.
Thank you for joining us. Dean Wood,
you've made my day. Thank you.
And thank you for joining us here on Card Sharks. We are indeed playing Card Sharks with celebrities. As a matter of fact, we have 3 weeks, 4 celebrities with us this week. The 2 highest scorers will come back in the 3rd week. 4 more next week. It should be very exciting. And, of course, we're going to guarantee a certain amount of money for these nice people. At the end of the 3 weeks, the winner overall, an extra $25,000 for his or her favorite charity. This week, we're playing with 4 nice people. Meredith MacRae, Marianne Mobley, Greg Mullavey, and this gentleman who's going to be coming out here right now to try to add a little bit more money. Fine man, nice actor, Mr. Ross Martin. Hello there. You're doing good.
You. Thank you. Wow.
That'd be nice. Nice,
that'd be marvelous.
That's
oh, you kids are great.
They really make you feel at home.
Yes, they sure do.
You are playing now on behalf of...
I am playing on behalf of the Cancer Immunization Center at UCLA.
And Ross is doing very well for them. Thus far, Ross has won $3,600 in our round-robin tournament for them. Cut the card?
Yes, I did that.
Let's add a little more right now. Let's open up the board and get to those money cards. Come on, Ross. Yeah, you're doing well. Playing the game very well. And it looks like you're having a good time, too.
Oh, I'm enjoying this thoroughly. Are you kidding?
That's
I wouldn't
nice.
Trade it for anything.
That's nice. $200 of new money we're going to give you now with the money cards. 3 cards, the better as you will on the bottom line. Up to the 2nd level, we'll add the 1 card, then the next 2. Couldn't count there, right, Lois? Remember, your decision how you bet them with a $50 minimum bet, and of course, the big bet, you must risk at least half the money. And unlike the main game, of course, if you get a double over here, you do not lose. The money just carries over just to help you along. Here's $200, Ross. Good luck. And, of course, you can change the base card on each level if you need to. Thank you, Lois. We'll start Ross off with 200 and a 5.
I want to change that.
Only change it once. You must play this. A 2. Great
you
card.
Bet. I'll bet it all higher.
$200 that this card is higher. Yes, for the queen.
I'll bet it all lower.
All of it again, trying to double it for 800. Yes, with a 3.
I'll bet it all higher.
Trying for 1600. Higher with an 8. 1800 as we give you the other 200, moving up the ace.
I'll bet it all lower.
Trying to double it. He does. First card you've got to be a little more careful about. The 3600.
How much have I won on this one?
3,603 cards to go.
I will bet $400 lower.
$400 lower than a jack. Right again. Now you're up the middle. Be very careful.
I will bet $50. Wait a minute. I've got 4,000, right?
Yep.
I will bet $100 lower.
All right. Well, we'd love to see another deuce right now. Come on. $100 lower? But for $100, you bought a good card. We're going to move it up. You've got a queen. You can play that or change it. $3,900. What's the big bet? You must bet at least half.
It's for a charity that I believe in with all my heart. It's for a charity that I think is going to make a major difference in the research in this dread disease. I'll bet all of it lower.
Double or nothing. Come on. Is this card lower? Yes! $7,800. Come on! That's nice. That's nice. $7,000. Ross Martin took a chance. And the UCLA Cancer Immunization Center is $11,400 richer. We'll be back with Meredith MacRae and Greg Mullavey right after this. That was exciting. That was exciting with Ross Martin. And he said during the commercial, He really feels there's so much to be done, and he just had the feeling that he could do a little bit more, and just why he bet it all, and it really paid off. That's nice. And among the people rooting him on, a nice group from Whittier at Cal High are here with us today. Well, two nice people coming out now as we can continue the round robin. As a matter of fact, first time in the round robin this week, we have a husband and wife against each other. Should be interesting. Janice will deal out the cards, and we'll meet once again Meredith MacRae and Greg Mullavey. Hello there, and Greg is playing in the red. Hello there. It's kind of an interesting challenge with the two of you against one another.
I'll say. The only thing is I'm a little scared. It depends on what kind of questions you ask us. You've been awfully personal this week.
We could have a marital spat right here on stage.
Oh, good.
Depending on the question.
You'd love it, right?
This is so interesting. Who are you playing for, Greg?
Cal Whittier High.
Try to get the sympathy vote.
Yeah, right. No, I'm playing for the... Sierra Club Foundation, yes.
Good.
And sorry, Kelly.
And Meredith?
I'm playing for United Cerebral Palsy.
Oh, all right. Two worthwhile charities. Greg's already won $1,000 for his charity. You cut the cards?
Cut the cards. Here we go.
We start the best two out of three with a question to Greg. Greg, we asked 100 married men. Oh, here we go.
Big trouble, I know.
100 married men. Does your wife have a sexy nickname for you that no one else knows? How many men said their wife does have a sexy nickname for them? A secret sexy nickname.
With coffee,
yes, I,
of course,
I
would say for sure. I mean, I do. I'm not going to repeat it on the air, though.
It's Glimmer. It's Glimmer, and it's not too sexy.
Glimmer.
Glimmer. Yeah. Those are his initials.
I would say yes. I would say. Yeah, 50%. I'm 50 out of 100.
50 out of 100.
Yes.
In this case, married men said their wife does have a sexy nickname. Ooh. No one else knows.
I don't really think so. I mean, we don't have a real sexy one. We've got a few personal nicknames, but nothing too sexy.
Turkey's good. Yeah, she tells me that a lot, Turkey.
I think I'm going to say lower.
Lower than that. If it's lower, you'll play your cards. If not, Greg plays his. And, of course, if you hit it right on the head, it is another $500 for your charity. The actual number of married men who said their wife does have a secret sexy nickname for them is 33. You're right, Meredith. It is lower. So Meredith gets the first look at the cards, starting off with a 5.
Oh, that's a tough one. I'm going to keep it. Keep it and go higher.
Playing it higher.
And that gives Greg a free chance
at a 9.
I can't change it?
No, you can't change it.
Can I change it? You did not hear the question.
Lower. Lower.
Lower than a 9.
No. That's a tough one.
No one goes any place on that one.
No.
This is a tough round.
Question to you, Meredith. Meredith, we asked 100 women. Do you find male bodybuilders with big, bulging muscles sexy? How many women said they do find male bodybuilders sexy?
I'm in big trouble on this one, you guys can tell, because he's not exactly Jack Willane.
You know what I mean? Hey, I got 2 years for the price of one.
I don't know. That's again,
because you went in the hopeless file, Greg.
You know, that's another hard question, because when you think of all our big heroes in films, Burt Reynolds and everybody, I mean, they're kind of big, but what do you guys think? No, I agree. I would say that most women would say no, that they don't find those guys with all the huge muscles that much of a turn on.
How many do find them?
I would say 38.
38 out of 100 women said they do find them sexy. Big muscles.
I am going to say, as Arnold Schwarzenegger would say, lower.
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 Even less than that.
Yeah.
So you agree with me, not too many.
Yeah, right? she agrees. Yeah, he agrees.
I'm going to go lower than you.
The actual number of women who do find male bodybuilders sexy is 19. It is lower. Greg's got it. And Greg, there is hope for us.
There is hope for us yet, yes.
Now you've got a 9 and you have control. You can play it or change it.
I want to change it.
Winning the question, you have that big option, and he takes advantage with a 4.
Higher
than a 4. A 7.
Free.
We'll move over the freeze bar, protecting that position for Greg. Question 3 to Greg. Oh, listen carefully. Greg, we asked 100 bachelors, would you marry a divorced woman who admitted she had been unfaithful to her first 2 husbands?
Oh.
How many bachelors said yes? How many bachelors said yes they would marry the woman anyway?
You're going to be next, pal. You know, I would say... 18.
18.
18, because, I mean, you're asking for trouble.
Ooh.
How many? He says 18.
This is a tough one. This is a tough one because I would think that not too many people would want to marry a woman that had fooled around that much. But on the other hand, you never know. Maybe she got it out of her system. So I'm going to say higher.
Higher than that. Oh, no. Did you notice the wonderful agreement you got
out
of the audience?
Yeah, I can tell. Thank you.
That's Whittier Cal High.
18 for Greg, higher for Meredith, and I hope you've made your decision at home as we find out the actual number of bachelors who would marry the woman who admitted she had been unfaithful to her first two husbands is 23. It is higher. Meredith has it. And Meredith has a 5.
I'd like to change that.
This time she wants to change
it. I have a good feeling. Oh, what a good middle. Feeling. Okay. Higher.
Higher than the 8.
Oh.
No. Another 4. It's not higher. Greg, you've got a free chance again with a 7.
Higher.
Higher than a 7.
No. Oh.
Oh. Fill in these the cards. What's wrong with them? We cut them wrong.
Right now, it's going to be tough for someone. Greg needs 3 cards. Meredith needs 4. Someone has a long way to go. With sudden death coming at you right after this. We're in the middle of game one in our best 2 out of 3 match. Greg with a 7 needs 3 cards. Meredith up the middle with an 8 needs 4. And we are at sudden death. Someone has to win this game right here on this play of the cards. Meredith, we asked 100 people. If a Rolls Royce driven by a millionaire rear-ended your car, but you weren't hurt, would you sue for whiplash anyway? How many people would sue the millionaire for whiplash?
I think, unfortunately, that a lot of people do take advantage of insurance laws, and I think that a lot of people do sue when they shouldn't, but I think that's part of human nature. Plus, the economy's messed right now, and everybody needs more money. I'm going to say, I think that 54.
54 out of 100 said they would sue the millionaire for whiplash.
I just want his Rolls Royce. That's all I want. Uh-huh. Just take the Rolls. I'm going to say... They say higher. I'm going to say lower. I don't think that most Americans... I think most Americans are honest. I'm going to say lower.
So you going with the honesty, you say lower. The actual number of people who would sue for whiplash, even if they were not hurt, is 29. You're right. It is lower. Very high number, though, 29. Now, Greg, it is sudden death. You've got control up here. You have a 7. You could, of course, change it. Try to turn over 3 cards.
I'm going to change
it. Meredith is up the middle with an 8. She needs 4. You can play it or pass it.
I'm going to pass.
You're going to pass it. Meredith, you need to get a ball to win.
I can't change it, right, Jim?
And you are right up the middle with an 8. You've got everything going against you. You must go all the way with an 8.
Okay, I'm going to say lower.
Lower than an 8. No, it's not. Greg wins it in sudden death. Game one to Greg. Another $100 for his charity, the Sierra Club Foundation. We will set up for game 2. Gee, if you win, you lose when you're playing your wife, right?
I can't. I'm going to hear about this when I get home. You know that, don't you? This is domestic strife show, isn't
That's
it?
Right,
is
that what
it is? I thought it was a card shark. Not get a divorce.
Same 2 decks of cards. Next card's off the top of the deck. And we start with you, Greg.
I want you to know that I usually am lucky. I just want to say that, okay? Not so.
Well, you may do.
My cards have been terrible.
Well, you could get 2 in a row now.
That's right. We'll you could. Sure.
Okay. Question to Greg. Greg,
no, she won't.
Greg, we asked 100 bachelors, have you ever had a romantic interlude in a compact car?
Whoa.
How many bachelors? How many? Now I know how they got whiplash. Yeah. How many bachelors have had a romantic interlude in a compact car?
I don't know anybody, I swear. I would say that a lot of people are seeing orthopedic surgeons because of this. I'd say at least about 60.
60 out of 100.
Meredith? I don't know. I think probably a lot of people have fooled around in cars, but since lovemaking
is more... She means kissing and things like that, you know,
Since lovemaking is more open these days, and because Americans have not yet taken to smaller cars, I'm going to say lower.
Lower. 60 and lower. I love your logic. The actual number of bachelors who've had a romantic interlude in a compact car is 61. Not lower by 1, Greg has it. And Greg missed a $500 bonus for the Sierra Club by 1. Greg, you start off this game with a queen.
I'm going to say lower.
Lower than a queen. No, an ace.
Oh.
Meredith gets a free chance to play a 6.
Higher.
Higher than a 6.
Oh.
3 is not higher.
I told you my luck.
Confidence,
terrible.
Confidence. We'll be right back
it's
with this unlucky
we're not
lady
in Vegas.
Right after
That's
this.
All I have to say.
So game one went to Greg Mullavey. Meredith MacRae needs this game. Greg with a queen and Meredith with a six. Both players need four cards. We pick up with question two. Meredith, we asked 100 millionaires, are you satisfied with the amount of money you have? How many millionaires said they are satisfied?
I would say that very few of them would be satisfied, because I think one of the ingredients you need to be a millionaire is to not be satisfied and to keep on trying new ways of making new money. So the question is, how many would be satisfied?
How many said they are satisfied, with the amount of money they have?
I'll say low, then. I'll say 13%. 13.
Or 13 out of 100.
13 out of 100.
Said they are satisfied.
Well, most of my millionaire friends, I don't know. I would say... Yeah, Meredith, you're probably right. I'm gonna get trouble with this. I'd say higher.
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 You think a little bit more are satisfied.
Yeah.
13 and higher. The actual number of millionaires who are satisfied with the money they have is 41. Very much higher.
That's surprising.
Yeah, because we didn't ask how many millions they had.
That's
true.
They
might have almost all of it. Greg, you've got a queen.
I'll go lower.
Lower. Yes, a four.
Higher
than a four, and eight.
Three.
Greg is halfway across the board for another crack at the money. And Meredith's got to catch up. Greg, we asked 100 married men. If you came home from work early, listen to this. 100 married men. If you came home from work early one day and found your wife and the mailman in just his undershorts. Is there any possible explanation your wife could give you that would satisfy you?
Absolutely,
well,
yes.
How many men said yes, there is
course,
some possible explanation?
I know what she'd say.
Them.
We're just sorting the mail, dear.
Just sorting the mail?
Sure. TV brought, you know, he's got some mail for the neighbors. He thought he'd drop it off here.
I've heard of special delivery, but that's ridiculous.
I'd buy it. Sure, I'd buy it. Sure. I'd say nothing's happening in that
he
bed.
He trusts me, you see.
Sure.
Okay.
So what percent, honey?
How many percent of men would what?
How many of the men said there is a possible explanation that would satisfy them?
Two. I'd say two.
Oh. Two.
Two.
After all this talk about how, just two.
Well, in this case, I think something is going to tell me to answer one way, because I had thought that Greg was going to say higher, but since he didn't, I am going to say higher, because it's got to be more than 2%. A lot of trusting husbands out there.
Zero.
Okay. The actual number of married men.
If it's 1%, I'm walking off the show.
Okay. The actual number of married men who said there is some possible explanation that would satisfy them is 26. You're still here. It is higher. 26. 26 of the most gullible people. Meredith, you've got a six.
I am sick of that card. I'm going to change it and get new luck.
Now winning the question, she can change it in a great change. Than a two.
All right. Higher.
Higher than a two. A seven.
Oh, freeze.
And now, Greg needs two. Meredith needs three. Again, we are at sudden death. We are down to the wire. Meredith, we asked 100 married women. Have you ever tried to get your own way by saying to your husband, if you really loved me, you'd say yes? How many married women have used that line on their husband?
Never.
How many have used it, right?
Yeah.
I think, this is a hard one. I think, unfortunately, that a lot of women have had to resort to that. I don't think that they should, but I think that sometimes when you're really desperate, you gotta try anything. So I would say, 73.
73 out of 100 said, if you really love me.
Just today at dinner, Meredith was telling me, last night at dinner, was saying, if you really loved me, now that Rolls Royce, no. I would say, I'm going to have to say lower.
Lower. You don't think that high?
Lower.
He's got faith in the women. The actual number of married women who have used the line, if you really loved me, you'd say yes, is 41. Whoa. Greg is right. It is lower. Yeah. Greg? Again, you have that all-important control in sudden death where you can play or pass.
Oh, play or pass.
I'm going to pass.
And again, Meredith, you've got to play it yourself. This time you're near the middle with a seven. You must get them all or the match is over.
Higher.
Higher than a seven. Yes, a king.
Lower.
Lower than a king. A four.
Higher.
To tie things up. No, she couldn't do it. And Greg wins it in sudden death with the last card. Could not do it.
And Greg again goes for the big money. We'll be back with Greg and Meredith in a moment right after this.
Hi there, I'm Todd Newton from Hollywood Showdown, the game show with the box office that actually pays you for a change. Hollywood Showdown is next, right here on Game Show Network.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.